Welcome class 11 student. As you know, we are discussing about dimensional analysis and dimensional formula and its application. Okay, so we had discussed two application. First was to check the correctness of physical quantity. Second was to find the relation between them. Today we will take third application, and that is called to convert the one system into another system. Other system to convert the one system into another system by using dimensional formula. Okay, so first see some conceptual points. Let's suppose you are given as you beta know system, there are three type of system, but unit syllabus you have to do MKS system and CGS system. M for mass, K for kilometer, M for meter, K for kilogram, S for second. Meter it is kilogram and it is second. Here centimeter, gram and second. If MKS is given, you can convert into CGS. If CGS is given, you can convert into MKS. But keep in mind, you have to full knowledge about dimensional formula and dimensional equation. Let's suppose you are given 1 kg and I ask convert into gram. So you better know MKS into CGS. Directly you can write 1000 gram. We know the formula. 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram. It means directly MKS converted into CGS. But if I ask convert the 1 newton, newton is the SI unit of force, okay, and I ask convert the 1 newton into CGS system time, this is the CGS system. Here we don't know what are the how much value will be there in unit and in time, and our physical quantity is force. So no doubt we have to take the help from dimensional formula. Okay, so now see there, our question is very clear. If 1 kg is given, directly you can write 1000 gram. But in the place of 1 kg, if I given to you convert the 1 newton into dyne, in that case we don't know how much newton have how much dyne. It means we have to take the help from dimensional formula. Here we are going to convert the MKS into CGS, as the question convert the one system into another system. Okay, so for this, first we will deduct the formula. This numerical value is this is called N1. This value, it could be M, it could be L, or it could be T. So it will be M1 power A, L1 power B, and T1 power C. It could be any value, it depends on physical quantity. Similarly, that value will be what? N2, and its value will be M2 power A, L2 power B, and T2 power C. Because you better know gram and kg, they are the dimensional formula and they are the numerical value. N1 into that much is equal to N2 into that much, because you better know 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram. So we can write the formula N1 M1 power A, L1 power B, and T1 power C equal to N2 M2 power A, L2 power B, and T2 power C. It's okay. Our aim is here N1 was given and directly we know the value of N2. But in that case, we have to, in second case, we have to find out the value of what? N2. So what value of N2? N2 is equal to N1. N2 is equal to, that we go in division. N2 is equal to N1. M1 upon M2 ka whole power A. M1 upon M2 ka whole power A. L1 upon L2 ka whole power B. And T1 upon T2 ka whole power C. So this is the formula for you. First we have to deduct the formula for conversion. So no doubt you better know 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram. In that way we can write N1 into that much is equal to N2 into that much. Here N1 is equal to 1 kg, N2 is equal to 1000 gram. That is already known. But in other case we will try to find out. So N2 is equal to N1, M1 upon M2 whole power A, L1 upon L2 ko whole power B, and T1 upon T2 ko whole power C. So this is the formula on which we are going to work. Okay. Now come to the question. Let's suppose our question is given, convert the 1 newton force and its SI unit is newton, convert it into CGS system time. Our question is there. 1 newton convert into dyne, it means you have to convert the MKS into what? CGS, because CGS system is dyne. and we are going to use that formula. So n2 equal to n1. If n1, if it is given 5 newton, 6 newton, 7 newton, n1 will be that much, but nothing is given, you have to take n1 is equal to always 1, because 1 newton is given, say n1 is equal to 1. m1 upon m2, m1 is the given, m2 you have to convert. Okay, so m1, this is the mass. Mass in MKS system is kg, so it will be 1 kg upon m2. You have to convert into CGS system, and in mass CGS system is what? CGS system is what? Gram. So 1 kg upon 1 gram. And okay, now wait for this. Let's first, force is given. The what of dimensional formula for force? F is equal to mLt power minus 2. We should know, because we are studying application of dimensional formula. Now compare the power. What is power? M power 1. You better know. So, and here M power A. So compare the power, A is equal to 1. L power B, here L power 1. So it will be L is equal to, again, sorry, not L, B is equal to again 1. And what about T? T power C, here T power minus 2. So C is equal to minus 2. You have to do this one for all. If force is given, you have to write down the dimension of formula for force. If work is given, you have to write down the dimension of formula for work. Since question is given, force SI unit is Newton, convert into CGS system, dyne. So we are taking the dimension of formula for force, because we are studying application of dimension of formula. Okay, now N2 is equal to N1, N1 is equal to 1. M1, that is given in MKS. No doubt in MKS, it is kilogram, 1 kilogram. Divide by, you have to convert into CGS, and CGS system is gram power A, and what is value of A? A is equal to 1. L1 upon L2, L1 is given, L2 we have to convert. What is L1? Meter, 1 meter, okay? L2 convert into, what is it called? Centimeter, 1 meter upon 1 centimeter the power B, and B again, we got 1. Similarly, T2, no doubt in both, it is a second. 1 second upon 1 second, time is second, here second, here again second, power what? Minus 2. It's okay. Now, you have to go through two way. You can convert 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram, or 1 gram is equal to 1 upon 1000. You will get same answer for both. So, N2 is equal to 1 kg, 1000 gram upon 1 kg, 1000 gram upon 1 gram power 1. 1 meter means 100 centimeter upon 1 centimeter to power 1, and here no doubt no need to convert, 1 second upon 1 second to power minus 2. Gram cancel, centimeter cancel, second cancel, it become 1 power minus 2 is equal to 1. No need to convert it. So N2 is equal to 1000 power 1 means 1000, multiply by 100 power 1 means 100. So we'll get N2 is equal to 10 power 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. N2 is equal to 10 power 5. So we got the formula 1 Newton is equal to 10 power 5 time. So this is the application of dimensional formula. By that way, we can convert the one system into another system. Okay. Note down all these things. And okay, let's suppose. Okay, one more question we will do. Then you try what given in your NCERT. Okay. Let's suppose. You are given as like this. Instead of this, you are given work, unit is joule. Work unit is joule, convert into CGS system erg on same way. So first we have to take the dimensional formula for work. Work is equal to M, L square T power minus 2. And compare the power, what you will get? Compare the power, A is equal to 1 and B is equal to not 1. It become what? 2. So what a formula? N2 is equal to, N1 is equal to 1. 1 joule is the MKS system. You have to convert into CGS. 1 kg upon 1 gram to power 1. 1 meter upon 1 centimeter to power 2. And 1 second upon 1 second power minus 2. Okay. Now convert 1 into 1000 gram upon 1 gram power 1. 1 meter means 100 centimeter upon 1 centimeter to power 2. And this will be cancelled out, it become 1. Centimeter cancel, gram cancel. We will get 1000 into 100 whole square. So we will get 10 power what? 7. So we got answer 1 joule is equal to 10 power 7 watt. RNA. Okay, so this is all about your conversion of one system into another system. Which physical quantity is given? First, you have to write down the dimensional formula for that. Then you will compare the power and then compare the power ABC and use the formula N2 is equal to N1 that and you can get the answer. Okay, so that's all for today.